Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, make sure you subscribe. So for today's video, I'm going to be doing a tutorial on the software I use to design my shirts. I use Imbrilliant Essential software, and that is linked down below. It's an affiliate link for Amazon, so go ahead and purchase it there. It works for Mac and for Windows computers, so it's perfect. So a lot of you guys want more in-depth information on Imbrilliant Essentials, just like the basics, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. Okay, so first things first, you would click File, New Page. So that pretty much opens a new design page for you so you can create your designs. So let's start with all the tools. This little paper is New Page. If you click over it, same thing. The next is to open a folder, next is to save, print, copy, paste. The arrows to undo, meaning erase the last step you just did. And then you can redo 3D, which means it will show your stitches, how it would look stitched out in 3D. Density map, a magnifying tool, you can measure on the screen. And this is a very important one. This is the stitch simulator, which I'll show you guys what that is as we go further into the video, and that's pretty much just showing you how you design the shop from start to finish. And next is just a selection tool, and this is the preferences window. So this is also very important. When you click on that, that's where you can choose your hoop size. Most of you guys have the PE 800 or flatbed, so that's the 130/180 millimeters. And here at the bottom at the sewing field, it transforms it to inches for you. So 5x7. I have the 8x9 hoop, so I use the 8x8, and so on and so forth. So you can choose your different hoop sizes from here. Let me close that. Next is, well, you guys actually do not have this tool in Imbrilliant Essentials, so I'll skip that. The next one is create a lettering design, the A. Actually, I forgot this, merge designs from your library. That I don't use often. It's just little shapes it has. I'll show you. It just has little shapes. Shapes. Let's see, Imbrilliant. Frame shapes, stuff like that. Okay, and then the A is to create a lettering design. And this works only if you already have imported fonts. Now, I bought a bunch of fonts, so you will not have as many fonts unless you already bought your fonts yourself. And if they are BX fonts. And I'll get more into that in a minute. So I just want to show you guys how to make a basic design. This tool, the merge a stitch file, that's the most important tool on here, because that is how you're gonna grab your designs you bought off Etsy or from our website kidscustomdesigns.com. that's where you would click to import the design. So I guess we could just go ahead and get started for something simple. A lot of you guys want to know how to merge two designs together, so meaning pretty much a number and a name, or just two designs in general. You want to put them next to each other versus just having one design. So we're going to go ahead and click this merge stitch file button. And I have a lot of designs, guys. Sorry. So what that means is you're going to pick a design you have. I saved all mine. Wherever you save it to, your downloads, whatever. So we can choose anything, really. Let's see. Here we have a cruise ship. My machine is a PES, so I'm going to go ahead and choose a PES. That's just the format of my machine. PES is for Brother Baby Lock. That's what that's for. You choose whatever file your machine uses. So I'm going to double click on a 4x4 design, and it brings it right in. It just imports it right to the library. And let's see. Let's say you wanted to add a number with it, maybe. So you have to find the designs you have that you purchased. So you look for whatever the title is. I know mine by heart already. So 420 applique PS. And I'm also going to choose another 4-inch design because they're both 4 inches. So I'll drag it up. So you can drag and drop, drag and move it just by holding it down and just moving. Someone also asked about resizing the design. So to resize it, you just click on it. You see all the black squares. You just pull it. Now you have to be careful with resizing. As you see here, it's not going to stitch out right. As you can see, there's like a black-ish line. So you don't want to resize all your designs. Some tell you you can resize them, some say you shouldn't. So just always look at your design and see what it looks like. That's how you resize. Big, small. So let me make it a little smaller so it would fit. So I just place them next to each other like this. So let's say you want to make sure they're centered, so you would just click on them. I do Command C, and there's a button right here. It looks like a little cross and centers the design for you. And you can move it up or down, whichever you would like. Let's see what else. You can also, let me delete this. You can also fit a design to the hoop. So let's say you have, let me switch it to a 130, 180, which is a 5x7 hoop. A lot of you guys have. So here's a design and you want to make it as big as possible so it'll fit in your hoop. You would just click this button, fit to hoop. And it made the design big. So this is how you know it'll definitely fit inside of your hoop. Not a problem. Okay, now I'm going to use this undo button. You undo. Okay, now let's find, let's see. Maybe let's do number 5 or 3. And it's too big, so I'll make it smaller. And you saw I just dragged and dropped and just moved it. And let's see. Butterfly. Let's do a 3x3 butterfly. A little tiny butterfly. And PES. So you can also layer in Brilliance. And it will erase this stitching. So where it overlaps, it won't put the put two satin stitches right on top of each other. It'll actually erase that when you go ahead and put it in your machine. So you can do that. That's why I love Brilliance. It's a good tool. So where you see this line right here, the stitching on the butterfly, it's not going to stitch that out. It'll erase that per se. So let's say, move it like that. Okay, let's leave it like that. So let's say you want to add a name. So in Brilliance, can use BX fonts, and you can use normal fonts. Now, BX is a lot easier, but I'm going to go ahead and show you what a normal font looks like. So, again, you bring it like you do your normal designs. Let's see if I can find it. Moana font. I used to use this all the time. So, you go find your format, PES. So, as you see, it brings up letter by letter. So, this is the torture with PES fonts. You have to bring in every single letter yourself versus just typing it out. So let's just put the name, let's just write Ace. Ace will be the name. So you can either double click and it'll bring it in, or what I learned a long time ago was you can command click, so you bring in more than one. Now you want to click an extra letter at the end, otherwise it would only bring in A, C. It won't bring in the E, because when I double click, it'll unclick it. So I'm just going to click the G. And then you see it brings letters right on top of each other. And what you also have to do is try to line them up correctly. So like I said, this is just a normal PES font. You want to buy a BX font. I'll show you the difference. So they're kind of lined up. So if you wanted, if you have a BX font, you would just click the number, the letter, the letter A, and you would just type it out, Ace. Easy, done, just like that. It's lined up. Simple, no problems. So that's it. That's so much easier, and that's why I love BX fonts. So always look for that when you buy a embroidery font, that it is in BX format, or they offer in BX format. Okay, let's go to this panel over here. I don't know what it's really called. I'm gonna call it properties, object panel, something like that. So right here we see the number 1, that means design 1, which is the number 3. And if you click on it, it tells you there's 3 steps. That's why it's design 1, step 1, design 1, step 2, design 1, step 3. So it is showing you that there's 3 steps in this design. You could change the colors of this design. Let's say you want the 3 to be pink, you would just click here. And well, here, threads, and click pink, and it is now pink. So it is easy to change colors on here. So for step 1, if you've made embroidery designs before, or if you haven't, it's the position stitch. So It's gonna sew on the shirt, and it's gonna show you the outline of where you're gonna be placing the fabric. You place the fabric, the next step, which is step two, which is the material stitch, tack now stitch. It's gonna go over the fabric so you know exactly where to cut. So those are, and the step three is obviously the satin stitch. Now, let's say you didn't know what each step was, you couldn't tell. That's where this stitch simulator button comes in. This is the stitch simulator button. You would click on that and you drag it and it shows you. Okay, it's doing an outline. Okay, next. Color is doing another outline. And then it's gonna be doing the satin stitching. So it shows you exactly what's gonna happen. So it makes it a lot easier. I use this so much when I had the P800 because you can't see anything on the screen. Really, of the P800, well, now I had the P770, now the PE800. And I also linked that down in the description below. It's an Amazon link. It says like my embroidery supplies. Click on that, you can buy the Brother PE800. So it just shows you what each step will be. So you have a better idea. And you can see how your design will stitch out. So I unclip that. And then it says next one is a two, so design two, which is the butterfly. The butterfly has a lot of steps. It has seven steps. So again, step one is the position, two, material, three is the satin stitching, and four is the antennas. And as you see, it highlights it for you with the rectangles. You can see what each step is, the body and the dots. So that shows you there. Okay, so you can also change the order of how things stitch out. So right now it's 1, 2, 3. Let's say you want to stitch the name first. You can click on it, right click. Sorry, my computer's slow. Move first, and it will go first. Okay, so let's say you want the name stitched last. You just go ahead and drag it and drop it. That's simple. Trying to think of anything else that is like basic beginner. If you do have a multi-needle machine, and you put two items behind each other. So let's say you make the dots red. And if you see the next step, ace is also red, it will combine them together. So it'll sew the dots and the name together, even if you didn't want it to. So keep that in mind. If you need it to stop for some reason, be careful putting two of the same color right next to each other. Something else you can do is, there's these two tools over here, which is flip vertically and flip horizontally. So if you flip something vertically, it just flips it, literally, it just flips it. And here's horizontally, it flips it as well. That comes in handy if you're trying to like mirror something. Okay, let's say you have a font that is very thin. So like this, I just big this font. It's thin and you want to make it thicker. So let's say you're sewing it out and it's having a hard time sewing, or the machine is eating it because the font is so thin. You can go click on stitch and click on the comp button right here, and you can slide it. I always do about 2 or 3, but as you see, it can get really thick or very thin. That's very thin, and I would never stitch something out that thin. But I usually put almost every font to 2, and that is that. Okay, so if we're all done, you would just click file, save stitch file as, and then you would save it. Something butterfly. Well, that's buttery. Butterfly. And you'd save it. And you would save it in the format of your machine. My machine is PES, that's why I already have it clicked. And then you click save. So I hope this tutorial helped some of you guys. This is like the beginner. So if you guys have any other questions, if at all about the software, just leave them down below. I'll do another video. I don't mind doing these videos for you guys because I know they help, and it's hard to find tutorials and help with embroidery software in general. So I have no problem. As long as I know how to do it, I'm more than happy to help you guys. Like I said, there's a lot of things in embroidery I don't even know how to do, but I just do what I need to do, which is make my shirts. So, and I know how to do things to make my shirts. You guys can also check out our website, and we have a Black Friday sale, guys. So everything on the website is 15% off. Everything. And orders over $150 will ship free. We have our ribbon, we have some fabric, and we added some more colors for the tool, although a lot of you guys have already been buying that today. So for the embroidery, so we also have the embroidery design. So here are some new designs we came up with. So you can go ahead and buy those, and Most of them are $1, $1.50. And the number sets, the applicant numbers are $3, $2.99. But remember, they are 15% off as well. You gotta put in code Black Friday to get the 15% off. Also, let me show you guys some of the fabric we have gotten. So I put up some of the glitter fabric. So it is super shiny. Let me show you. As you guys know, I use these fabrics a lot. It's hard to see on here, but it is super glittery. And I have them in a few different colors. So I would go ahead and buy that. They're perfect for appliques. Better than just using a solid color, especially on a girl's shirt. So I would get that off the website too. Also, if you guys have any designs that you guys would like us to digitize or try to digitize or create for you guys, just go ahead and leave those commented down below and we'll, you know, just work on them in the order they come. Any designs you guys would like, just let us know. So that is it for today's video. Please make sure to give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel if you are new. All right, guys. Bye.